Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to generate images using prompts locally on your PC with the help of an AI model. Now I know many of you might not have a powerful PC, don't worry, neither do I. That's why we'll be using Google Colab and its free GPU support. If you are unfamiliar with the process, just follow along and you will be good to go. First, open any browser and search for Google Colab. Click on the official link and once it loads, you will see an interface like this. On the bottom left, click the New Notebook button to create a new notebook. Once your notebook opens, it will look something like this. You can even rename it to something more meaningful, like this. By default, Google Colab uses CPU for the runtime, but we need to switch to a GPU for this project. To do that, go to the Runtime menu at the top and click on Change Runtime Type. In the pop-up, select T4 GPU and then click Save. Now the GPU isn't connected yet, so click the Connect button on the top right corner. Wait for a few seconds and it will connect. Once connected, you can check the RAM and disk section to see the resources provided by Google Colab. It gives you 12.7GB of system RAM, 15GB of GPU RAM, and 112GB of disk space. While this might seem like a great setup, it's not enough to run very large AI models, like the Flux1 Schnell model from Black Forest, which I tried to run and ended up using all the RAM, causing the project to crash. If you have a more powerful system or use the paid version of Google Colab, you can experiment with such models, they are really good. For this project, however, we'll use the Stable Diffusion model to generate images using prompts. The setup process is similar and works smoothly with the resources available. So let's dive in and set everything up. Now let's write some code. First we bring in the PyTorch library. PyTorch can use your computer's CPU or a faster device like a GPU to speed things up. Then we define a function called getDevice to check which device our code should run on. Inside the function, we first check if a CUDA-enabled GPU is available using torch.cuda.isavailable. If it is, we return CUDA, meaning the program will use the GPU for faster processing. If CUDA isn't available, we check for Apple's M1 or M2 chip support using torch.backends.mps.isavailable, which would return MPS for those devices. Finally, if neither is available, we fall back to CPU, which is the basic processor every computer has. At the end, we call the getDevice function, store the result in the device variable, and print out which device we are using. Now hit Shift plus Enter to run this cell. You can see here that CUDA is available. Next, we are importing the Stable Diffusion pipeline from the Diffusers library. This is a super powerful tool for generating images using AI models like Stable Diffusion. Next, we are loading a pre-trained version of the Stable Diffusion model using the from pre-trained method. Here we specify the model name as a Stable Diffusion V1.5. You can see that I am following the official Hugging Face documentation. Then we set torch dtype to torch.float32, which tells the model to work with 32-bit floating point precision for better accuracy. And we add a variant FP16. Which is a lighter format that can speed things up if supported. Finally, we call dot to device to move the entire pipeline to the hardware we selected earlier, like a GPU, MPS or CPU, depending on what's available. And with this setup, you can work with any models you want. Keep in mind though, that this might take some time to download the necessary training data. So grab a coffee and let the download complete. Once the download is finished, all we need to do is write a prompt, run the cell, and the model will generate an image for us. However, keep in mind that this is a basic model trained on only a few million parameters. As a result, the generated image might not always be accurate or visually appealing. If that happens, you can simply rerun the cell to generate a new image. Now, if we had a more powerful system capable of running advanced models, like the Flux1 Schnell model, we'd be able to generate stunning, high-quality images effortlessly. That said, even this small model consumes a significant amount of resources, so make sure your system can handle it. One thing you might notice is that running the same code generates a different image each time. This happens because the diffusion process is stochastic, meaning it relies on randomness to create images. If you want consistent results, you can control this randomness by setting a seed. And that's it. I hope you found this video informative. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more exciting AI content. Take care and I'll see you in the next video.